done.
I heard you wanted me dead, but you see.
Who wanted you dead?
You. I heard you called people to come and kill me.
I would easily kill either one or two.
You would easily kill. You would.
Yeah, I just know where to find you, man.
Lol.
Sunday on a party, Sunday on some chill out.
Dunamis, are you exposing me now? This man. Anyway.
That's how much I know where to find you.
Oh, well. The fact that you know my house, I'm going to change my address from today onwards. So let's talk about, first of all, the song. I don't think we've talked about it a lot, this song, Change the World. Yeah? Take us through the song. What do you feel like inspired the song, you know, to say you're trying to change the world? And also in that light, I would also want to know, how easy is it to change the world?
The song, the concept basically came through, Exomind is the one actually who came through with the concept.
Mm-hmm.
He felt like a lot of people actually aspire after changing the world, you know, they feel like, yeah, we can change the world, but each time they do that, they forget one thing that's most important, the mm-hmm. way they should change themselves first.
Mm-hmm.
So the focus is that usually outside, not inside.
Okay.
So that's where they miss it. And we brought the concept of it. Before you do that, before you change the world, focus on yourself first. Can you just change yourself? Change the anger, the attitude, the whatever, everything that is inside you. Then you can be able to change the world outside you.
Hmm. Now, speaking about changing people changing themselves, I know you're one person that faced a lot of criticism. Is there anything that you're going to change about yourself, if you were to change any?
I will change the only things that God wants me to change, because I communicate with him daily.
Okay.
So if he tells me, yeah, this is what you have to change, I will. Mm-hmm. And the rest of others, really, when it comes to other people, the way they look at me, the criticisms that you're talking about,
mm-hmm.
basically, it doesn't really move me, man. I've been here for a decade now. I know first it's success, then it's stress after the success, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I'm aware of the equation and how it goes, where there's no way you can be, you know, successful, you can blossom, and then people don't look at you negatively. I'm aware of that, so it doesn't move me so much.
Hmm, interesting. So let's talk about something now that's very interesting, also as we talk about interesting stuff. You have a song that has been made for you, right? By Exomind, who you're also currently working with. You know, how do you take that? You know, obviously you receive a lot of love. People tell you, I love your music, I love you, you're doing good, you're doing that. But you know, a whole song, your Jesus Christ, imagine those ended. Those ended in the days of Beyonce and Jay-Z, eh?
So, to be honest with you, man, I really, really, really felt the love for that song, because I didn't know he was doing that song.
Mm-hmm.
But like, we planned it.
Mm-hmm.
He just brought it, he was like, I want you to listen to something, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Then he brought the song to me and I heard it, I was like, wow.
Mm-hmm.
You know, one thing that moved me about the song is the level of appreciation that the kid has for me.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I'm always aware of the environment, everything that's going on around me. But I never, it's hardly ever a case that I get applauded for things that I did positively.
Mm-hmm.
And when I saw someone go out of their way to write a song about that,
mm-hmm.
it really moved me. I was like, wow, this is positive energy that we need in the industry, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I really, really embraced the song a lot. And I was even playing it now before the interview as well, just to show the level of appreciation that I have for that song, basically. He says I'm the truth, you know. And I know one thing I had as a revelation type of,
mm-hmm.
is when you are the truth, people are always scared of the truth.
Yeah,
people
true.
Are always not comfortable with the truth.
That's true.
When you are that person, people will... One more or the other, it's more like an unpopular narrative,
mm-hmm.
that is not worked on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I realized that I'm that, and I expose the truth so much that people feel like I that's who I am, man.
But let me ask you this, Ne. Like I was saying, that criticism and negativity or hate is what you get a lot, right?
Yes.
You said something earlier on about people having their bitterness and how they feel, you know, stuff like that. And obviously, it would say how a person treats you or reacts to you is normally how they feel about themselves.
A reflection of how they feel about themselves. Yeah.
So what do you feel like... you do that people hate so much? Because I'm like, yo, you know, right now we're looking at Malume Vector. He's also getting so much criticism for just being himself, you know? People are talking about things like his weight and you know, what do you think people are so afraid of? You know, if you can just like try to accept, I know you're a person who's always just sharing knowledge and experience and you know, can you just sort of make us understand this one?
Yeah, there's a whole lot of ideas that are coming in that I have to talk about, but I will specifically narrow it to this one.
Mm-hmm.
It's always something, the drive, the zeal, the ambitions that people have. You know? Mm-hmm. When you're alone, you have a certain drive and ambition that I want to achieve a certain thing. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Now, you look at the location, you look at the environment, and you're like, there are a lot of hurdles that I have to cross over to achieve that. Now, when you can't, when you feel narrowed and pressed and you're not able to cross over the hurdles, now Quizzy comes in and Quizzy is able to just jump like that, easily like that.
Mm-hmm.
So like, we're in the same place, we're at the same spot. How come Quizzy is able to do what I'm not able to do?
Mm.
There are two things that will result from that. One is you will feel inspired. You will feel like, wow, I'm going to ask Quizzy how he was able to do it. Two, there is a feel of anger that will come. Jealousy, envy.
Mm-hmm.
Why wasn't it me? Why isn't it me?
Mm.
That? Then if you allow that feeling, trust me, my brother, it's just going to change everything around you.
Hmm.
And suddenly, obviously, you will start voicing out your feelings about Quizzy. No, I feel like Quizzy is whatever. Oh, Quizzy, no. Oh, Vector, this and that, you know. But if you're comfortable with yourself, when Vector does cook, you applaud him, you feel like, wow, there is a Lesotho person who is actually exposing the talent that Lesotho has. Here is a gateway for all of us.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, let's appreciate that, you know.
But also, would we say, because now I would think, okay, cool. I know you're a person who, you know, I'll say is not too social media about, you know. You just like even on your social media activity, you're not very like the vocal one, you know. But so far, I've not seen you upload Malume Vector. What's going on? Do you have beef with him?
No, I don't have beef with him because I follow him even on Instagram,
mm-hmm.
on Twitter. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
I've never even imagined having beef with him because he's a good guy from my perspective. I mean, I've met him a couple of times when we're shooting Megahead's video, and they were cool dudes, man. Both of them are cool dudes, man.
Mm-hmm.
And they're young, man. I wouldn't even think of that, by the way, you know, because I actually appreciate that they are doing even more than I did. That's important to me now, you know,
mm-hmm.
what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So that other people after them also are going to have easy access, you understand? That's how the game goes. That's how we should understand the game.
Yeah, open up the doors.
Don't do that, you know, they don't understand it like that. So I'm exempted from that, my G. I can't look at people who are successful and feel intimidated because I'm in my own space now, comfortable, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? My bank account is okay.
And speaking about your bank account, I heard that you...
I don't have a problem with any other person outside, you know, my scope altogether, yeah.
Wait, speaking about your bank balance, I'm sorry, I have to ask you this. If it's too personal, I heard a rumor that you're about 200,000 rands away from being a millionaire. How true is that?
Who said that?
I had a rumor. I was like, hey, Matung, what? Dunamis is a millionaire. Hi, man, Dunamis, come on. Please, come on now. Don't...
Are you trying to make people
vote
me or stuff?
No, but that's what I'm asking. Is it true that you are 200,000 rands away or Maluti away from being a millionaire?
Facts.
It's facts.
Facts.
Jesus Christ. Okay.
Facts. All facts.
Okay. Where do you get the money? Is it the music? Is it? Are you human trafficking people? What? Where do you get the money?
Three days ago.
Mm-hmm.
I. You know, my music plays a lot in SA, you know,
mm-hmm.
at royalties. I get a lot of royalties from the spins, you know. That's one thing that I encourage other people.
Oh, yes. And I think I saw a screenshot circulating of your email address where somebody was sending you thousands.
I'm under South African Music Rights Organization, so I'm able to get each time any radio station spins my track, I get a certain percentage out of that. So It actually, that's where I get most of my cash, you know.
Hmm.
So basically, artists need that, my G. Artists need that because, do a whole lot of things that need money, and people don't understand that. Okay, it's not easy just seeing people celebrate you out there, and then when you go to the field, it's empty. You know what I'm saying? A lot of us have gone through that a lot, where people are saying, yo, do the house, I'm gonna do now, you know what I'm saying?
Mm.
But when you go home, you know, you're struggling and stuff like that. We need to clear that. What about respect, Dequeezy? Respect comes with that also. Respect comes with when people see you living that affluent lifestyle. Well, I'm not gonna respect about those of Africa or Fetabalos. Why? Because we see them flashing all these nice cars and all that stuff, and we believe they are gods. They're not. Instead of us, you know, boosting our own people, boosting artists, celebrities, Lesotho, or people who are public figures, boosting them and putting them to that level. And then, trust me, we're going to give them the same respect that we give, I don't want to call names of people on the other side, but that's how it is, man. That's how it is, basically.
All right. Dunamis, we're going to run out of time shortly, but I really think you're doing so well. Keep it up. Like you're saying, you're going to be a millionaire soon. Does this mean, obviously, a lot of money comes with a lot of responsibilities. What responsibilities do you have now? Are you getting married anytime soon? I keep asking you this because, the people want to know, are you getting married?
Everybody's asking me that. When God is willing, I will get married.
Okay. When will he will? Like, can he will?
When God is willing, I told you that I communicate with him. So when he tells me this is the pathway, take it. I'll take that route. But now I'm focused on a whole lot of things. I'm focused on pushing other artists. I'm focused on, you know what I'm saying? The focus is actually on the company as it is, KOL, just to see blossom. Because I realized one thing also. People need a heart. And music, a lot of talented people are out there and they're struggling to know where they submit their albums, how, who's pushing them, the marketing strategies and all that stuff. Even the Sambo thing, if you can ask me how many artists are under Sambo, few of them, you know what I'm saying? So it's that area that I need to build on in Lesotho Mona Kibonomi. People get that exposure, they get that talent exposed. You know, they get everything that's good, man, because literally I've seen that in Joburg, I've seen that everywhere, you know. So it's time our own people inherit that as well.
I see. Somebody on Facebook is asking you about the song Redemption. Says Davatana does this, they just hit home. You know, take us through the song quickly as our last question. It's half past time is out, all right?
Yeah, Redemption, I did a song because I felt unappreciated, man. I felt like I did so much. I became the gateway to a lot of accessibility also to Roman Leona on the other side, you understand? But I never felt appreciated for that. Basically, I still feel like that anyway. That's why maybe I embrace Pina and Ohaho. But at the end of the day, all it is, man, is when I did Redemption, I was more focused on how can you do so much, but still people look at you so little. You understand what I'm saying? Bewildered me, shocked me. I couldn't understand how this happened, you know? And now, when I did Redemption, I told the story from the beginning. It actually narrates the same way as the story of Jesus, how he came to save people, but still they crucified him.
Mm.
The same people who he came to save.
Mm.
So I looked at it like that. I was like, oh, what did happen to him? Who am I as a human being? You understand?
Interesting.
Who am I to try to say I can change the world? Who am I to try to say I can bring positive impact in the sort of music industry? When someone who actually did save our lives became crucified for this, the very same cause. So that's when I did Redemption. I was like, I gave you people mustard seed, I gave you glory to the speed, I gave you G.O.D., but now it's time for the redemption, because I felt like there's been a lot of things said about me that were not even true, so I needed to clear myself from all those, because, you know.
I have two questions, all right? I have two questions. One being, first of all, you're going to be closing off. The second part is going to be, you're going to be closing off with your social media pages where we can check you out on social media. But before you get there, I'd really like to know, your album art created so much controversy. People were like, you photoshopped, you used somebody's picture for something. Like, it was a lot. Please take us through that. What was going on? What is the situation with that song, by the way? That album art, by the way.
I'm not a graphic designer. I just tell someone what I want. And I felt with this one, I did it purposely because I needed to. You know what I'm saying? When you become so much of a villain, when people look at you, you're a villain, you devise mechanisms that, to counteract every single voice outside I already knew something was going to come because it's me, you understand?
Mm-hmm.
So I took an opportunity of doing, because Undefeated, the album is about being undefeated, and obviously it relates to boxing, and I was like, oh, Tyson, let me do this.
Okay.
So now, who is a graphic designer, and I was like, I need it like this. I know it's going to make people talk, and it's going to make my album sell, and it sold a lot because of that.
And that's good. Lastly, social media, time is out.
Social media, Dunamis, that's DunamisRetz, Mulefe. Dunamis Retz Mulefe on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram. That's where you find me. And I always respond to people who talk to me, you know.
Please say that when you close off. That doesn't that you say that intimidates people. Duna, please say it.
I do what?
That thing that you do that people get intimidated by when you say it. Duna! Shout out to you, man. Thank you very much for being on the show today. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Dunamis. Exactly. It, 28 minutes lying before we get to 6 o'clock. 28 before I get out of here, it's going to be Jericho coming in with the Ultimate Zone. Until then, Exo Mind, it's called You Someday. Don't go anywhere.
I want to be you someday. I want to be you. I want to be you someday. I won't be the truth. I wanna be you someday. I wanna be you. I wanna be you someday. With the sun on two. Yeah, I know they tryna ride my wave, tryna learn my moves. I'm gonna lose my friends someday. That's what progress do. They tell me